It's not fair!
I'd like to call to order this secret conclave of America's media empires. We are here to come up with the next phony baloney crisis to put Americans back where they belong, in dark rooms glued to their televisions too terrified to skip the commercials.
Well, I think...
NBC, you are here to listen and not speak. I think we should go with a good old-fashioned public health scare.
Yeah.
A new disease. No one's immune. It's like the summer of the shark, except instead of a shark, it's an epidemic. And instead of summer, it's all the time.
Now, I hate to be the guy who derails what everybody else loves.
He loves being that guy.
But, Janice, we do have standards. This can't be a made-up disease. The only moral thing to do is release a deadly virus into the general public.
We do have something we've been holding on to, but it hasn't been tested. Get over here, NBC.
Well, we certainly believe in testing, but I... Oh, yeah.
So, we've got our deadly disease. Now, we just have to blame it on something that's in every household, something that people are a little bit afraid of already. House cat flu is coming, people. The Center for Disease Disinformation predicts with some degree of probability that the house cat flu might spread in the following hypothetical outbreak pattern. So, petter beware, that warm body on your lap just might be ready to destroy your tender fiddles. Springfielders are advised to stay tuned for more information if they experience any of the following symptoms. Mild thirst, occasional hunger, tiredness at night.
Oh my God! Specimen Z isn't Carter's body. What is it? Specimen Z is a cure for cancer. Carter didn't die. He cured himself.
Hold it right there. Damn it, Brian, you broke into my lab.
Carter, you found a cure for cancer?
Well, I didn't come up with it. A couple of eggheads I hired did.
How long have you had this?
I don't know. When was that Who Let the Dogs Out song?
You've had this since 1999? You know when Who Let the Dogs Out came out?
It's a song about dogs and letting them out. I could have you arrested for breaking in here.
Carter, you've discovered the holy grail of modern medicine. Why the hell would you keep it buried like this?
Well, I'll tell you why. Because there's far more money to be made in treating a disease than in curing it. Why cure someone of cancer in a day if we can treat them for a lifetime and bill them every step along the way?
What? That's insane! Carter, what you're doing here is criminal, and I'm gonna tell the whole world about it.
Is that right? Who's gonna believe you? The internet? You'll be just another nutjob left-wing blogger. Security!
Everything's fine.
No, it isn't! Get in here! Ah, damn it! You bastards!
I don't know why you're surprised by this, Brian. Big corporations never tell the truth.
We need somewhere else to dispose of this plutonium.
Yeah, just find the biggest idiot on our payroll and slip it in his bag. Ooh, that's a bingo.
Good mac and cheese.
I've had better. Down at the train station.
I'll have to check it out sometime.
Now, the best mac and cheese I've ever had is at a bowling alley in Ogdenville.
I am pretty full.
Breadcrumbs on the top.
I'm on my way!
That bag, surely it's attended. Unattended bag!
Panic!
Tom, what do you think?
I think we're gonna blow it up and let the bleeding heart liberals ask questions later.
Well, now, why can't it be blown up by a woman of color?
5, 4, no time for a full countdown.
Ooh, it's dinner time.
This just in, the suspicious bag detonated at Springfield Union Station today contained deadly plutonium, which can only mean one thing. A terrorist plot. Enough radioactivity was released to create 17 Hulks and a Spider-Man. Here's an artist's conception. Quite disturbing.
I admit it. Everything I've said about terrorism till now was fear-mongering. But today, I monger the truth. To protect our city from all future bombings, dirty, clean, dive, or carpet, we have hired an outside consultant from London, England.
Does he have a cute accent?
Why don't you be the judge, young lady?
Ooh, he sounds just like Paddington Bear.
My name is Nigel Baker Butcher. Sleepy London Town. Once upon a time, the only problem we had here was from overzealous Cockney flower sellers. But in London of the 21st century, the watchword is vigilance. London is now ringed by the most comprehensive array of surveillance cameras mankind has ever seen.
Constitution would want?
Well, I'm Wally of Wally's Framers, and this is exactly what I want.
How many personal freedoms are we willing to give up in the name of security?
That blonde girl thinks she's smart like us dark hairs.
Again with the blonde. Why in the world would the color of the hair on someone's head have anything to do with the intelligence within?
Yeah, you're so right. I'm smart too. I got Joe to promise to leave his wife when I turn 50.
Yes. Now all in favor of these cameras, say cheese.
Cheese!
Those opposed, say I hate America. Motion carries. Next up, motion to limit terms of city officials. All in favor, say aye, have sex with animals.
I do have sex with animals, but I am not in favor of term limits.
I want a camera on every light pole. I want two hidden cameras there. Open camera there. Hidden. Cluster, right there. Yes.
You ain't gonna like what you see.
All right, boys, let's see the dark underbelly of our fair burg. Okay, we got a litter bug on F6. Double homicide in progress on Q20. Woman sunbathing topless on R15.
So sadly, the most popular reality show in England is no more.
We cannot found a country based on war!
We cannot found a country that is afraid to fight!
Rabble!
Mr. Franklin, where do you stand on the war issue?
I believe that if we are to form a new country, we cannot be a country that appears war-hungry and violent to the rest of the world. However, we also cannot be a country that appears weak and unwilling to fight to the rest of the world. So, what if we form a country that appears to want both?
Yes. Yes, of course. We go to war and protest going to war at the same time.
Right.
If the people of our new country are allowed to do whatever they wish, then some will support the war and some will protest it.
And that means that as a nation, we could go to war with whomever we wished, but at the same time act like we didn't want to. If we allow the people to protest what the government does, then the country will be forever blameless.
It's like having your cake and eating it too. Think of it. An entire nation founded on saying one thing and doing another.
And we will call that country the United States of America.
Wow! I get it now!
Oh, I'd love to see New York. We could all go with the bus company's special super-sitter fare.
Ooh!